finally, a good shark movie that isn't pathetic. Kinda.
Remember, if you watch too much YouTube, you're gonna get square eyes, rotten brain.
Welcome back to Square Eyes Rotten Brains. We got a movie review for you. This is an entertainment channel and we're gonna get down to it straight away. I love shark movies. I've always loved shark movies, but shark movies, they've just been shit lately. Really, really shit. The last good one was Shallow. The Shallow's Shallow. That was good. That was okay. That was bearable. But today I've just watched the brand new, got released today, Great White. Great White 2021 movie, and I liked it. Now, warning, I'm gonna try not to give any spoilers. I'm not gonna give away how it ends or which characters actually die, because we know there is gonna be deaths in it because it's a shark movie. But I'll try not to do too many spoilers for you. So spoiler warning, just in case I slip out. Now, what is this movie actually about? And did you even know this movie was even coming out? Because I've been waiting for this one. I've been quite excited because it looked pretty good. Now, basic story plot is this couple, an American female, Australian male, they own a charter. They own a flight charter, take you to little islands, wherever you want to go. And this gets stranded, or let's just say, without giving spoilers, they get stuck out on the ocean with the people that they're taking out with them. Now, this area of the water that they're in, they say in the movie, shark season is over. Shark season is over. But what's this big, great white shark doing in the waters? What? Why? This is a killer shark movie with a decent CGI great white shark. And actually, I found that there was only, in my notes, there was a shark fake as fuck one. I only gave shark fake as fuck one. So the rest of the shark scenes look pretty damn good in my opinion. Now, as it is predictable, like all shark movies, the survival storyline is pretty familiar, like all the shark movies, with the old fin pointing and gliding towards the victims. What disappointed me was they never ever said where in Australia this actually is and takes place. Because the visual effects of this movie look absolutely beautiful when they're going and flying over with their sea charter, seaplane, whatever you want to call it. It looks great. But they never say whereabouts in Australia this is. So the couple's charter is actually going broke and they finally get this call and they get another job and they take these Asians out to an island, and then we're out at sea because it's a seaplane. So I don't want to give away too much, but that is the one scene that I will say the shark is fake as fuck. That's where the shark is fake as fuck when it comes near the seaplane. Apart from that, everything is pretty good. I did jump a fair few times. I jumped a lot, actually, to be honest. There's a lot of scenes where the shark did make you jump. And that's great, and that's what we want you to experience during these types of movies. Is it up there with Jaws? No way. Is it up there with The Reef? What is the second best shark movie ever? Which is an Australian shark movie? No way near it. It is down where The Shallows. It's with The Shallows. It's up with that. It's pretty good. It's nowhere down here with the Sharktopus versus the fucking mega shark, Kasaurus. It's nowhere that bad. So it's pretty good. There's lots of moments in the movie where you just want to punch some cast members in the face because they annoy you. Stupidity, but there's always stupidity in shark movies where they deserve to get killed. It's only a movie they can get deserved to kill, okay? It's okay. So some of them deserve to get killed. There is one character in the movie that I couldn't wait to die the whole movie. That was fantastic. Now, this is a bit of a spoiler, so fast forward through this. It's not saying who survives or who dies, but it is giving away a little bit of the ending here, so this is a spoiler alert, but the end scene is a ripoff from The Little Mermaid. The end scene is a ripoff from The Little Mermaid. Fuck it, it's a spoiler. I'm giving a spoiler away here, spoiler alert. Please look away, spoiler alert, if you're gonna watch it. the end scene, I'm not telling you how the shark dies or if the shark wins, I'm not telling you that. But the end scene is just like in The Little Mermaid when it comes into a broken ship. Oh man, just, I'm gonna put it on the screen there. Tell me that is not the same. That's where they got the idea from. I actually thought it was pretty brilliant. And one note before I give my final score and tell you if it's worth watching and worth going to the cinemas to see or watching it at home, because this is not on Netflix and all that, remember. This is, we even downloaded, is that illegal? Is that illegal to say download? You gotta go to the cinemas and see this. You gotta go to the cinemas and see this. Not download. Cinemas. My wife watching it, her theory is when you're paddling, and a shark comes up to the boat, the way to survive is just put the paddle in its mouth and the shark will be trapped with a paddle in its mouth and that will help you to survival and the shark will die. best quote ever. And I want to see it happen in a movie now. It never happened in the movie, but I want to see it happen in a movie now. I like my wife's theory, but it won't work. So out of 10 in the shark movie scales, I'll give this a solid 6 out of 10. Definitely worth the watch. I enjoyed it. I'll never probably watch it again, but I really enjoyed it. There was a few bits that pissed me off. And there's always bits in movies that piss everyone off. But there was a few bits that pissed me off. Apart from that, 6 out of 10, solid. Up there with The Shallows, not as high up there with Jaws, not as high up there as The Reef, but it's pretty good, and it's not a bad brand new shark movie compared to all these Sharknados and all these other fucking stupid shark movies that come out lately. Thanks guys, thanks for watching my review. Hopefully I didn't give too much away, which I think I did, but in the end, if it's, if you watch this to see if it's worth watching or not, yes, it's worth watching. At home on your couch with some popcorn, enjoy it. At the cinemas, I wouldn't have wasted my money at the cinemas, but I did enjoy this. Thanks, give a thumbs up if you want some more movie reviews. This is Square Eyes Rotten Brains YouTube channel. This is all about entertainment, this channel, and a little bit of everything for everyone. See you soon.